Look, it's Gary.
Hi, everyone. Happy Monday. Hope you had a great Thanksgiving weekend. Jerry's sitting out on the deck, actually reading Gary's book and Growing an Edible Landscape. If you haven't got it, you got to grab it over at, I'm sure it's on Amazon. It's a really good book. So him and Mac were having fun. Now, it's windy again today. For some reason, Mondays, the wind always kicks up. We've had, I think this is our fourth day of wind.
Yeah, it's day four. Not to complain.
And we're talking strong wind. It might have died down a little bit now, but we were kind of worried we might lose some trees. But anyway, we are just right inside the kitchen door and still showing you the beautiful outside. I know a lot of you are crazy, crazy cold, like in the 20s, down into the single digits last night, getting snow. But hopefully you still have some Thanksgiving leftovers to keep you warm and cozy on the inside.
Well, it is about time that it got cold. I mean, it is December, right?
Almost.
So we knew this was coming.
That's right. So we had an absolutely frigid 55 degree evening the other night. We were outside with our coats and our hats and just enjoying the outdoors. So hopefully things are not too cold in your neck of the woods. You're still able to get out in the garden.
Let's show everybody our outdoor set, half indoor set.
That's right. So today is all about container gardening. So we are not going to be without containers in our container garden video, inside or outside. So we've got here a beautiful tomato plant. This is a Celeste tomato, which is a cold tolerant tomato. Another one over there in the corner. And lots of Smart Pots containers, which is our very favorite growing container. Some little ones right here. And I've got some 1 gallons to show you right on my table in front of me. So it's going to be a fun one. We're going to give you some hot tips to grow a cool weather container garden. And this little one over here in the 15-gallon Smart Pots is a determinant tomato. Trying to remember the name of it, but we are getting tomatoes on this one here and have been absolutely loving it. So Smart Pots containers, good job.
All right, Cliff, I'm going to jump into the chat here with you. All right.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm going to grab my water so we're all set. And welcome. Happy Monday. Smart Pots is here, container garden experts. Cliff, our resident master gardener, is here. Nisha's not able to be here today, but she said to tell everyone hello. We've got all kinds of garden support, people here to give you advice, and lots of gardeners in the chat from all over the world to help support your garden addiction and garden habits. So you're in the right place, especially if you're a first-time gardener. You expert gardeners, jump in and answer questions as we go. Okay, Southern Sky Tennessee Garden, love it. Can't even begin to imagine wearing shorts out here. It's 43 degrees today. Wow, we do not know what cold is like here in California. I'll definitely have to admit it. So we love to have fun with it. And Smart Pots is here checking in. Thanks, Smart Pots, for being here. Fred P. Sonic, a chilly 33 and overcast in Tacoma, Washington. Just started drawing out next year's flower beds. It's a great time to start planning for your next year's garden, especially if you're in for the winter time. 808 Ladybug is here from Hawaii. I'm sure it's much warmer out there. Always fun, probably 75 or 80 degrees. And I asked in the pre-live stream chat if anyone has their Christmas lights up or has started their holiday shopping. We usually get our Christmas lights up the first weekend of December. So next weekend, we'll get the tree up, get our laser lights out front, which is about as detailed as we get, and start our shopping, which we're doing all online today, or this year. Julie, hello. Great to have you here. Patricia Treadway, she decorated for Christmas already.
Yeah,
so she is rolling it there in Arizona. And nice and holiday spirit. Esther's daughter, great to have you here, Esther. I'm in Florida and my carrots, beets, and lettuce are starting to grow. Perfect time for cool weather gardening in Florida and southern states, southern climates like we are here. Kay Talabaugh, hello, Kim and Jerry. Great Monday growing. So great to have you all here. And we are growing all winter long. So Don't go away. We're growing right along with you, even if you're in cold temps. So let's jump into some hot tips today on container gardening. So container gardening is so much fun. Whether you have a deck, patio, a large space where you just want to expand your garden, I love growing in containers because they're so darn easy. And you all know my container of choice, of course, is smart pots. And there's a reason why I like them. I've used lots of different containers over the years, but this one is a really nice durable fabric. And the great thing is they're super durable, they're aerated. But the thing that I like best about them is they don't get root bound. Now, I've grown in all those plastic and ceramic containers over the years. I pretty much got rid of most of them because I was constantly having to transplant my vegetables or my flowers or what have you into larger containers because they were not doing well. The roots would circle around. They would outgrow the containers. They couldn't take up water and nutrients. They would either die or get overheated. They just didn't do well. But since I use smart pots, they air prune. They develop like a fibrous kind of root mass rather than a root circling. So they grow better. You can grow more larger vegetables in smaller containers. And it's pretty much all I use now. And there's all different sizes, which is great. So no matter what, if you have a big area or a small area to plant in, I absolutely love these. So there's lots available over on my website and also at smartpots.com. So the first thing when you're growing a winter container garden is to manage your expectations. Now for me here in Southern California, we pretty much live in a frost-free area. However, things do grow a lot slower in the winter time. And especially in my backyard, because I don't get near as much sun. The house shades the backyard for the majority of the day. Right now you're seeing the little bit of sun that is left behind me here, which is maybe about a foot or two from my back fence. So most of the garden that you see in the summertime that we grow on is in shade already, and it's only noon here. In fact, it's all been shaded for a couple of hours. So 3 to 4 hours of sunlight if we're lucky. So if that's you, I mean, the sun is much lower in the sky in the wintertime. So a lot of people, even if you have a nice sunny yard, we're just not getting as much sun. So manage your expectations, even in containers. However, something that's great about containers, especially smart pots, is you can move them around fairly easily. So especially if you're growing smaller containers like the little 5 gallons that are behind me there, that blue one and the black one, they've got handles. So you can easily pull them and chase the sun or chase the shade, whatever the case might be. In fact, even some of the larger ones, like the 15 gallon that this tomato is in, these are from the Costco website, the 15 gallon 3-pack. They're very reasonably priced, but they have really nice handles on them. So you can easily move them around into the sun or into the shade, whatever the case might be. So that is one of the things I like about them. They're lighter than like the big heavy ceramic pots. So you can really drag them around. In fact, we have these on the other side of our deck in the sunlight right now, cause that's where I get the most sun, and we just move them over so that I could show you guys how well the little tomato is doing. And I love going out. We just picked our first little round of tomatoes from this plant just over the weekend. So if you're in a warm winter climate, if you can find some cold tolerant tomatoes, I grabbed a couple transplants at the garden center. These have been planted for a couple of months. If you can find those still at your garden center, a lot of garden centers don't have them anymore. You could still get one planted and just put it in a nice sunny spot. And it could do very well. Mine's actually doing terrific. So tip number one is manage your expectation. You might not get as much from your container garden in the winter as you do in the summer, but at least you're still getting something. And we're going to talk about what to plant in just a moment. Actually, I just covered tip number two, and that is strategic placement. Do make sure you scope out your yard for your winter container garden, and you probably don't want to just put them in the same place you put your summer containers. So take a look before you get your container garden planted. Take a look at your backyard, kind of observe it over a couple of days period, and notice where you get the most sun. So like I mentioned, the sunniest spot right now for us is two places. Number one, on our container deck. You probably have seen it in some of our videos. It's where we did the container garden series. It's where we planted our salsa garden in the smart pots over there. It's on the far side of our deck. That actually gets the most sun right now. It's a small little corner, but it gets about 6 hours of sun right now. The sun just kind of peeks through on the side of the house, and it's a really nice spot. The other spot where we get a lot is down along the back corner of our fence. I know it's a little bit blown out behind me there from the sun, but where our elevated raised bed is down there, I've got lettuce and greens growing in there that's doing very, very well. So definitely look for the sunniest spot in your garden. And the great thing about growing in containers is it's no problem. You're not going to be moving a huge raised bed. You just pick up your containers and you just scooch them right over there. Now, if you're growing in the winter time, in the northern gardeners, for the winter time, for those of you that can't grow outside anymore, you might be thinking, how in the world can I possibly grow a container garden in the winter? Well, you can grow an indoor garden. And if you've been watching our YouTube channel recently, you've seen our indoor garden series. And I always encourage people, don't stop growing in the winter. You're going to get kind of the winter blues. You're going to get cooped up. You're going to want to see the green inside. So you can definitely grow in a very simple winter container garden. My favorite thing to grow inside are greens, like this lettuce right here, little 1 gallon containers, and little tiny tomatoes, which I've got right here. These are in the from the Smart Pots October box with the Breast Cancer Awareness Smart Pot. Aren't those cute? These are little mini micro toms ripening up right over here in my inside container garden. And then my microgreens, which I actually left right over here on my table. Let me grab them. Some of the easiest things you can grow inside. So don't give up. You can definitely still grow your indoor container garden in the wintertime. And one thing that you can really, anybody can grow inside, no soil, no grow lights, are sprouts. And I've really been getting into sprouting. And in fact, that's actually the theme of our December Grow Your Groceries with Callie Kim subscription box. So you can grow these right next to your kitchen sink. No grow lights, no soil. They grow in a jar, just super easy. And these literally grew from tiny little seeds to this beautiful jar of healthy, nutritious sprouts in about 3 to 4 days. And I'm not kidding you. These are super nutritious, delicious. You can make salads out of them, put them on soups. So anybody can grow an indoor garden, whether it be in smart pots containers or in little jars. And by the way, the December Grow Your Groceries with Callie Kim subscription box is now available. Just went live on our website yesterday. It's a fun one. It's a sprouting spectacular theme, and you get 4 packs of sprouts. And I love the little bonus in this month's box is actually a little plantable bow with butter crunch seeds that you can plant right in your mini containers or in your containers outside. So you get 2 of those in your box. You can celebrate Christmas and even pop a little gift bow on one of our gift it boxes and give it to a friend. So these are really amazing little, like really amazing little Christmas gifts. Okay, I've been talking for a while, so let's go into the chat, see what questions you have about container gardening, about growing a cool weather garden, container garden, and we're gonna talk in just a moment about some specific veggies that you can grow outside in your container garden here in the wintertime. Okay, let's jump in here. Ramona Jolly, my plastic 5 gallon buckets are starting to break. Smart pots will replace them. I'm glad to hear that. Cliff, have you gotten any mushroom kits yet? So Cliff, I'm sure you probably already jumped in there and answered that question. But yeah, the smart pots are not gonna crack and break like the 5 gallons do. In fact, you can toss them right into the washer. I do that all the time. After I'm done growing something, I empty the soil out, rinse the kind of soil residue out, throw them in the washer. I usually will put them on the heavy duty cycle and they come out looking like new. You don't want to put them in the dryer, but just air dry them. They're pretty much almost dry by the time they go through the spin cycle. And that way you can keep reusing them time after time for years on end. Okay, let's see here. Julie says, the most difficult thing about Michigan winters is that it's gray all of the time. Last winter, we had sun only 5 of 90 days. Wow, that's tough. Where do we go here? I always used long to be where 808 ladybugs in Hawaii lives. Yeah, I think that is the tough thing about a lot of people have with the wintertime is the sunlight. I know for us, we had tons of clouds last year too. We were kind of getting a little bit down. It's like we needed the bright sun. So that's one thing I love about having something growing indoors. It's a great way. Gardening is so therapeutic, and it's a great way to beat the gardening blues in the wintertime. So do yourself a favor, get an indoor garden planted. And Linda brings up a good question here. Do we need a code to get up to 60% off your sales? Today's Cyber Monday, so everything on our site is on sale up to 60% off. And no, you don't need a code. All the markdowns are there for you. All Calicum seed collections are $10 and under. So this is going to be our biggest sale of the year. You definitely don't want to miss it. Everything on sale, the garden kits, the books, the seed collections. So head over and grab it. The indoor garden seed collection, microgreens are a great one to grab, as well as the December box. And by the way, you don't have to get a subscription if you want to buy a gifted box. If you love our boxes, they make great, unique, one-of-a-kind holiday gifts. Grab them before they run out. Okay, Patricia, your box will be shipping later on this week, right to your door. It's going to be a fun one. Okay, let's see. What other questions do we have? Let me scroll through the chat here. And yes, Julie, keeping a green indoor growing will definitely help the seasonal affective disorder that comes along with the gray there. Okay, Eric from Smart Pot says, I've heard that it's even more about missing the color green than it is about lower sunlight that leads to seasonal depression. Indoor gardening fixes all the problems in life. It definitely helps there. And Eric, that's a great point. The colors green and blue, like Jerry, I always feel like those are so therapeutic. So whenever we go on vacation, we always have to be around green and blue. That's one reason why we always go to the ocean for our vacation, because it relaxes, energizes us, and just gives us kind of just a new lease on life. So highly encourage you to get some green growing inside now. Start now, even if it's with a little tiny jar of sprouts, because it's going to really help lift your spirits during those winter blue times. Okay, let's head into tip number three. A hot tip for growing a cool weather garden is make sure that you choose cold hardy or cool hardy veggies. Now here in California, we can pretty easily, not super easily, but we can grow tomatoes in the wintertime. If you start soon enough and if the roots get established, it's not going to be near as productive as it is in the summer, but you can definitely still grow it. But you'll have the most success, especially in frost-free areas, if you grow your cold hardy veggies. And by that, I mean veggies like greens, lettuce, kale, chard, collards, pretty much anything that's in the fall garden seed collection, broccoli, cauliflower, kohlrabi. Has anyone grown kohlrabi? I'm gonna try growing again this year. Often we get some hot spells in the wintertime that prevent the kohlrabi from bulbing up, but it is a really amazing kind of odd looking vegetable, but very, very delicious. Cabbage is one of my favorite ones. In fact, just yesterday I started a whole nother round of the minuet cabbage, the sorrento broccoli that was in the August subscription box, the bok choy lettuce, and all kinds of greens. So definitely starting a new round now for you Southern gardeners. Now is a great time to either plant it directly outside in your garden beds, your containers, or start it from seed indoors. Now, one reason why I like starting from seed indoors, even right now, when you can easily direct seed them right in your containers, is because of my lack of sunlight. So, and I forgot to say, peas and radishes are one of the easiest crops that you can grow that go from seed to harvest very, very quickly. But if you're having a lack of sunlight issue like I am in the wintertime here, start from seed indoors, or even I started some from seed outdoors just on my side area where I get more sun. Grow the vegetables to size, to a little transplant size, a few inches tall, and then it makes really quick work of just heading outside and popping them in your containers. So a lot of times what I'll do is I'll clear out my containers that are dying off from my warm weather veggies. I'll leave all the soil right in place in my smart pots. Makes it really quick to just throw in some extra compost, some organic fertilizer, and mix it around. Make sure it's nice and moistened up. And then once my transplants are ready and all hardened off, I can go and pop them right in my containers. And it makes quick work of gardening, because we all want to save time in the garden and save money in the garden. So start from seed and grow those cold hardy veggies for a lot more success with your container garden in the winter. And I'm telling you, it's so much fun, because in the summertime, I really can't go grow lettuce here in California. It's way too hot. And I really miss just plain and simple lettuce, right? There's so many different beautiful varieties. So now is a great time to get your lettuce planted and just plant the rainbow. There's so many beautiful colors. I love our lettuce seed collection because it has five or six different varieties of lettuce. The bronze mignonette is one of my favorites. It's a beautiful kind of purplish tinge lettuce, along with the red romaine, the Paris cause, which the romaine lettuces tend to be a little more heat tolerant, maybe around up to 80 degrees. So if you do live in that frost-free zone, the heat tolerant lettuces will do really well even in the winter time. So grab one of these. Another one of my favorites is the specialty greens. Do you realize how expensive specialty greens are in the grocery store, if you can even find them? Sometimes you can grab them at the farmer's market, but we're talking endive, tatsoi, some of the Asian greens, even cress, things like that, that you can grow literally for pennies that are all in our specialty green seed collection. And then the kale. I plant, I think, three or four different kinds of kale in our fountain area planter because it does get a lot of sun in the winter. And kale is a superfood. We love it in our smoothies. So definitely the greens are the good ones to plant in the wintertime. And also carrots. Now, I don't grow a ton of carrots because it's just a space issue for me too, because you pull them once and then they're done. But if you love carrots, our carrot seed collection has four different varieties. And the kids really enjoy planting these and pulling the carrots right out of the ground. So definitely some good options for you over on the website for cold, hardy vegetables. We always try and give you lots and lots of resources. Now, for container gardening too, don't forget the pollinators. They're still out there in the wintertime. A lot of them are hibernating. If it's, if you're in a cold northern zone, you may not be seeing your pollinators, but don't forget, you southern gardeners, to plant for the pollinators too. I just started a whole bunch of the cool season flowers. We'll pop them out there and get them going. So when the pollinators are out there foraging for food, there will be plenty of food out there for them. And then they'll be pollinating your vegetables at the same time. So do grow your cold hardy vegetables. And indoors though, you can grow your little tiny Tim tomatoes from our indoor garden seed collection, your herbs, your micros, and your greens. So fear not, like I said, for you northern gardeners, get out there and get your indoor garden planted too. Okay. Back into the chat here. Esther says, I hardly ever see bees. So in the north right now, they're probably hibernating in their hives, moving very, very slowly. But plan on for your spring garden is just getting a ton of flowers out there in the garden. I think a couple of years ago, I planted an entire pollinator garden in our red planter area. And I planted zinnias, dahlias, nasturtiums, all kinds of flowers. I could not believe what a difference that made in my garden as far as the bees, the butterflies, even the birds coming in. And we just really enjoyed seeing all the pollinators come in. Sunflowers are great pollinator attractors. So I've got tons, I think five or six different flower seed collections. The red flower seed collection is a super popular one. Those are flying out the door over the weekend for our Black Friday, small Saturday and Cyber Monday sale. So make sure you check those out over on our website as well so that you can plan to bring the pollinators in next year. So more and more of them. Did Mac come in? A lot of people are saying let Mac in. So I'm not sure if he went wandering around or if he came back in the house somewhere behind me. Okay, and the real 1970, what is the smallest container I can grow broccoli in? If you're growing a full-size broccoli plant, I would grow one probably in this 15-gallon smart pots right here. That's a great size. Full-size broccoli plants are quite large. So the bigger, the better on that one. However, though, if you want a smaller, more compact plant, I would suggest a broccolini plant. What's the name of it? The Sorrento broccoli is a great one. That was in our subscription box a few months back. It's a nice compact plant and it goes from a seed to harvest, I want to say in 60 days. And you could grow that one in a 5-gallon container, a 10-gallon or a couple plants probably in a 15-gallon. So you definitely do need, though, a bigger smart pot for a larger full-size broccoli plant or for a full-size cauliflower plant. And kind of how it works is you can definitely grow them in smaller containers, But the bigger the container, the larger the more room the roots have to grow. And that way you're going to get more out of your plant. And Smart Pots does have a good resource over on their website. What size container should I use? And I think I have a link for it in the video description, or just head over to smartpots.com and check it out. And that'll kind of help be a guideline for you as you're planting. And by the way, over at Smart Pots, you can use the code CALIKIM and get 10% off any of your containers. So that's a really great deal going on over there as well. Okay, scrolling up through here, Julie says, I never interplanted flowers in a vegetable garden, but collected your flowers collections to do it next spring. Great idea, Julie. And there's absolutely no reason why you can't plant flowers with vegetables. In fact, I encourage it. Not only is it absolutely beautiful to have flowers spilling over your containers, I had some marigolds in there, but the cold took them out. But it just looks so pretty to have, if you've got spillers over the edge, different colors, it looks gorgeous, but it also brings the pollinators right into where you want them to be, right near your vegetables. So do plan for that next spring. One of my favorite spillers is nasturtiums. And those of you that have been with us for a couple of years know that how the nasturtiums kind of spill over the different levels in our garden bed. They grow over the winter time. When the sun hits the garden more in the springtime, they start to bloom. And they're absolutely stunning, and the pollinators love them. So that's one of my absolute very favorite flowers, cool weather flowers to grow. Okay, let's jump back into tip number four. Hot tip for a cool weather container garden is don't overwater your container garden, and do make sure you fertilize it regularly. In fact, don't overwater or underwater. But I think a lot of us tend to overlove our plants and tend to overwater. Now, one thing I've noticed with my container garden is we've had so much wind that even though they're all hooked up to drip irrigation, the wind is just really drying out the plants and really drying out the soil. So you really do have to pay attention to what's going on in your weather at the time. So my containers definitely need some extra water right now. So I'm going to be going around or either bumping up my drip irrigation schedule or just hand watering. You know, giving them some spot water now, especially during the windy period. So do check your containers. They dry out quicker than your in-ground garden or your raised beds. And one thing that I like to do is kind of use my finger as a moisture meter. So you might have a moisture meter, which is super handy, but you do want to check it regularly. And your indoor garden is no exception. You can look at the top of your soil to see if it's a light brown color. That's one clue. And you can see here, I just watered these this morning, so it's a nice dark brown color, plenty of moisture. But you can stick your finger in the soil, and if it feels wet, you don't need to water. But if it feels dry, you definitely do need to water. Another clue is if you pick your container up, if it's a smaller container, and it feels lightweight, that means there's not a lot of moisture content in it, and it probably needs watered. So do pay attention. You're gonna kind of get the feel of your containers, how they feel when they have a good amount of moisture content. And you'll kind of learn, you know, through trial and error, if you're new to this, how your containers feel when they're watered just right. So when we picked up this tomato plant this morning, that's exactly what I said. It's not heavy enough. It needs to be heavier. So I'm going to have to go out and water my containers, give them a little bit of supplemental water because of the wind that we've had. Now, a really important thing for containers is fertilizing regularly. You're watering them until the water runs out the bottom. The water and the nutrients are draining out a lot quicker. They don't have like the deep roots that they do, the deep roots of your in-ground gardens to really pull that up. So you got to water them more often. And you have to fertilize them regularly if you want them to be productive, right? So a lot of people say, wow, your container garden looks beautiful. It's because I fertilize it about every 10 days or so. One thing that's super, super has made it a lot easier is I got one of those hose attachments that you can put your fertilizer right into. So I fertilize regularly with Vermistera worm tea, and Vitality. And then at the beginning of a plant's life, I'll use a higher nitrogen fertilizer, such as fish fertilizer, something to really jumpstart their growth and help them to get a lot of green, healthy growth right off the bat. And then I switch over to the Vermistera products. But you can put the liquid fertilizer right in your hose end fertilizer, attach it to your hose, so you're not continually filling up your water bottle, adding the fertilizer, and it just makes it easier. I know Eric got one of those too. from Smart Pots. He swears by it. And you can, you can adjust the setting on there for how much fertilizer you want your plants to get. And that way it just keeps it regular. So it's one of those things that's a time saver. We got to save time in the garden because we all have busy lives. And if you make it easy and make it time efficient, it means that you're going to do it. So I want to hear in the chat if any of you have ever used those types of fertilizers. And I almost don't use anything else now. It just makes it so much easier and so much more fun to fertilize your vegetables instead of feeling like a chore. So tip number one is manage your expectations. Tip number two is place your containers in the sunniest spot possible. Number three is choose cold hardy vegetables. Number four is don't over underwater, but fertilize regularly as well. And we'll share tip number five in just a moment. But before we do that, let's head into the chat and answer some questions here. Okay, Kim Harris, I planted some lettuce seeds last week in my raised bed, but the neighborhood cats decided to use it as a litter box. How can I keep them out? Okay, hands up in the chat if that has ever been a problem for you. I think all of us have dealt with that. One thing I did when that was happening to me in our front yard garden is I stuck little plastic forks with the tines up throughout my garden bed, and that did seem to help. So if anyone else has any suggestions for that, we could all use some little tips. It's one thing I love about our community here is people are always willing to jump in with helpful tips and suggestions, no matter what question comes up. Okay, Cliff, great suggestion here for a tomato variety. We used to grow Oregon spring tomatoes here and they worked great. So yeah, in the southern zones and even in the northern zones, later in the summer, early fall, probably in the northern zones, look for those tomatoes that are cold hardy. And that'll give you the best chance of having the longest crop of tomatoes. Like I said, I planted these probably back in August or September, and they're still going strong. In fact, probably doing better than my summer tomatoes did this year. We had such weird weather. Okay, Esther, you're going to have to let us know how that worked for you, but it's worked pretty well for me. Okay, let's see. Oh, great idea, Tina. I put skewers with a pointy side up to deter squirrels. So let's hope those squirrels don't take a flying leap onto one of those skewers. But that will definitely help keep them out of your garden. So let me know if any of you have tried anything else here. Okay, let me scroll back through the chat here, see what's growing on. And Smile Urban Garden says, I tried to overwinter carrots outside in the ground. It didn't work for me because of the ground freezing. And then in the spring, when the ground thawed, the carrots were mushy. Okay, you might be able to leave them in there for the first few light frosts of the winter time. In fact, for those cold hardy vegetables, a lot of them will survive light frost early in the season. In fact, the frost will often make them sweeter. So there's some vegetables that are very cold hardy, very frost tolerant, freeze tolerant, like your kale, chard, collards might freeze and then thaw, and they'll be okay. But some of the other ones like that, if you get real hard freezes, they might not do so well. Okay, Jay, here's a good suggestion. The only thing that works to keep cats out of the garden bed is covering it with bug netting. So yeah, if you've tried everything else and nothing has worked for you, that might be a really good option, is to cover it with tulle or some type of the winter covers. The garden ag fabric, I believe it's called, that will work really well too. I'm having great success using tulle to keep the squirrels, the birds from pulling up my seedlings and from also keeping the bugs from chewing my greens. So did a video on that a couple of weeks ago, maybe a month or so ago, and they're really growing strong under the tulle. So we'll have to do a little update video for you on that very soon. Okay. Since people are talking about frost, let's talk about tip number five when you're growing in a container garden, and that is to protect from frost. Okay, we don't often get frost here, but you always do want to keep a watchful eye on the weather no matter where you live, because you can get those unexpected frosts or unexpected wind. We didn't have any wind on our weather yesterday or today, and it's been absolutely crazy. So not only keep an eye on the weather, but of course on your weather app, but of course look outside and see what's going on too. But if I was to be getting a frost tonight, I would definitely want to be covering my tomato plants. very frost sensitive. So I would grab an old quilt, or I would grab a heavy duty piece of plastic. I know there's lots of frost blankets out there. If you've got a cold frame, you can pretty easily grow cold weather greens underneath a cold frame. So keep an eye on the weather. And if you're growing frost sensitive plants, you definitely want to cover them and provide them with some protection. Now, that is the beautiful thing about containers as well, because often in a small enough container, you can pull them inside. With this 15 gallon, it has got two handles on it. So Jerry and I could easily lift it up, bring it inside if we were expecting a frost tonight. So that's one thing that's great about containers. Now, we do also have larger size of smart pots, like the little shorty 3-foot raised bed. And there's a 2x4 urban raised bed, it's called. You've probably seen that in our garden down below. Obviously, you can't bring that inside. It's just too heavy. But you can cover it and do a lot to protect it if you are getting frost. So simple frost protection is great. If you really want to get more into it, there's lots of, I'm sure there's lots of videos out there on YouTube on how to build a more involved cold frame that can really protect your cold hardy vegetables when you're getting hard freezes, or a greenhouse. Of course, if you have a heated greenhouse, that can really do it too. So depending on, you know, how easy you want to go or how involved you want to get in the wintertime, there's definitely ways to grow just about anything. But the containers are a great way to grow because you can bring them inside or very, very easily cover them with a quick, simple winter cover if you're getting a light frost or even a heavy frost. Okay, I want to hear from you. What are your frost protection tips for containers? I just thought of another one too, and that is, if you've got those big storage tubs or storage totes, you can just take those and put them right over your smaller plants. Like the blue one there is like a pak choi, which is frost tolerant, but might not do so well in a hard freeze. So put a big storage tub over it, or even another larger size smart pot to help cover it and protect it on a frosty night. Okay, suggestions in the chat here. What do you do to protect your containers from frost? And Marilyn Mitchell has a great suggestion for carrots. Harvest carrots at the end of November. Let's see, it scrolled by me here. And before they freeze and thaw too much, first frost was the end of October. So yeah, pull them out of the ground. If you have like a root cellar, they'll do well in a cool, dark place in your root cellar. We don't have basements in California. So when we harvest our root vegetables, we try and eat them fairly quickly so they don't spoil. But I know Cliff in Idaho, I believe you have a root cellar, Cliff. Pretty sure you've talked about that before. You could probably store all kinds of vegetables down there in the root cellar. Okay, let's see here. Linda, thank you very much for your order. We'll be getting your orders out as quickly as we can. We've got a ton of them coming in, but we'll get them to you so you can get your seeds planted and get your Christmas gifts ordered early, because shipping, a lot of people ordering online this year. So shipping could be, you know, a little bit delayed. So do make sure you shop early to avoid the rush and to avoid any shipping delays. That way you get your Christmas gifts on time. We have lots of great garden kits. And of course, our subscription boxes, the gifted boxes, make excellent gifts as well. Okay, I've been placing old sheets and blankets, Ramona, over your containers for frost protection. It's a great idea. I recommend getting two or three different options ready and just stashing them away in your garage or your garden shed, so you're not rushing around. If you are going to get a frost, just keep them handy, keep them at the ready. So within minutes, you can dash out and protect your plants. So really keeping organized and keeping being prepared is half the battle sometimes in gardening, and will really go a long way towards saving you time when the frost does come. Okay, organic gardening. I've seen people put non-LED Christmas lights in and around their plants that are covered to protect them a bit. So yeah, great suggestion there. It's a, you know, lower voltage, puts out a small amount of heat, not enough to be dangerous or catch fire or anything like that, but maybe test it out a little bit, keep an eye on it. That's a great suggestion, and thank you very much for sharing that. I've seen that as well, you know, online in different spots. Okay, let's see here. Cliff, my sister who lives a half a mile away, always has an amazing root cellar. We share a lot of resources. Extra potatoes are always in there. Number one, super nice that your sister lives so close. Number two, great that you get along enough to share things And, you know, if you don't have family members close by, you know, a friend or a neighbor, maybe you can share vegetables back and forth or share resources like that, the root cellar. It's always great to just make friends with friends and neighbors and whoever lives near you. And then you can share your resources that way too. Okay, what do you use as coasters for the Calican pots from Linda? Okay, great question here. For the inside 1 gallons, I have these little 8-inch saucers, and I believe this link is in the video description. For the larger ones, the 5 gallons, there's a 15-inch that I use outdoors, or you can put like a little tarp underneath your larger pots there, or a heavy duty piece of plastic would work too. I think it was Eric that suggested a while back that you could get one of those, the hot water heater drip trays, maybe the mud mats that you can get at the hardware store. Some people might even want to place them in kiddie pools. I've seen that as well. So those are good options for you. Let's hear in the chat what other things you've used to use as drip trays underneath your smart pots. Be great to hear that too. Okay, Terry, I usually water and feed every 7 to 8 days. Is that too much during the winter? Terry, I wish there was a general answer I could give for how much to water your plants, but you are going to have to just check your plants every couple of days, depending on the weather. Things can change. Usually my drip irrigation is sufficient for my containers, but with the wind, like I mentioned, it's dried it out quicker. So you're just going to have to check and see how your plants are doing. Every 7 to 8 days sounds like really not quite enough unless you're getting a lot of rain. So it all depends on the weather where you live. Okay, Cliff, here's a little tip here about the root cellar. It's built underneath the shed. My brother-in-law likes to build stuff, but it's perfect. So lucky for you, Cliff, you have a brother-in-law that likes to build stuff, and that's a perfect spot to keep your root vegetables where it's cold, or cool, that is, but not too cold and won't freeze. Joyce Bovey, great suggestion. Kitty litter boxes for under your containers. That would work great as well. And let's see here, any other questions here or comments in the chat? Fred P. Sonic, I wrap my fabric pots with leftover carpeting. Seems to keep them warm and still have some airflow. So great suggestion on that as well. You're protecting the roots, which are you know, the most important thing to protect. You can also heavily mulch your plants as well on top, 2 to 3 inches of mulch to help protect the roots during a cold snap also. All right, let me scroll through here. Any other container garden tips? Love to hear in the chat. And we can all just help each other out and grow a lot of food together with all of our suggestions. Okay, Stephanie D. Question, when growing lettuce inside, how many hours should the grow lights be on? You know what? I pretty much keep it simple with my indoor grow lights. They all stay on the same amount of time. It's worked out really well for me. They're 18 hours on, 6 hours off, and it doesn't really matter if it's a tiny little seedling or a little lettuce plant like this. They all stay on the same amount of time, and so far they've all done just great. So I wouldn't worry too much about adjusting the amount of time for different plants, different sizes of plants. A lot of people say, can you grow things all the way to harvest with the LED lights that I suggest? And here, I don't know, you guys, what do you think? Think we can grow to harvest? Here we go, my little mini tomatoes ready to harvest, doing just great under the LED grow lights. I don't worry too much about the red lights, the blue lights, the color lights. I just get the same lights and grow from seedling all the way to harvest, and it works out really well. I found that just keeping things simple rather than worrying too much about all those kind of details works well, because if it's simple, I'm gonna do it. If I get too complicated, I'm going to get overwhelmed and I might not do it. So just keep it simple. The most important thing is you just get started. If you've never started your container garden, start with 1 or 2 things. I mean, lettuce is by far the easiest. You can plant it from seed. You can grab my indoor garden seed collection. It's got a bunch of different types of seeds in there, from greens to herbs to micros. And then the Tiny Tim tomato. So that would be a great one to start with if you're brand new. And then you can just plant 1 or 2 vegetables at a time. get some experience with that, get your first harvest, and then plant a couple of more next time. You're going to absolutely love it. One, if you're starting out, I recommend grabbing the indoor garden mini kit. So you kind of have it all together there. And again, it's all on sale right now. It includes the indoor garden seed collection and three of the Cali Kim 1 gallon smart pots of different colors. So it's a great basic kit to start with. They also make great gifts. And then make sure you watch all of our indoor garden seed collection, because we're going to walk you through it step by step on how to grow your indoor garden. If you're growing outside, we've got the container garden seed collection and the container garden series. So we're all about providing you the resources that you need to grow your own food. And then we've got a great community here for questions. If you need support, always join us on Mondays at noon Pacific time. We're here to answer your questions for you. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and close it out for today. What a fun time talking about container gardening. You can grow just about anything in containers, as long as you're growing in the right size. And even if you make a mistake and plant something too big and too small of a container, you've learned something from it. And then you can just adjust whatever mistake you made and correct it for next time. There's always something delicious you can grow in a container, even in the wintertime. So I think camera guy's going to come back on here for the end. And what a fun day. Hopefully next week we won't be as windy and we can be outside. And we're going to be having a couple fun videos coming up this week. And be back next Monday at noon Pacific time.
Yeah, I hope you all have been enjoying our extra yardage footage on Instagram. If you don't follow us there on Instagram, do so, because we are showing really kind of how our whole backyard started. And there's some great memories there, and you'll see Kim doing some things that you can't believe that she has done. So follow us over there, and love all the comments and the feedback that we're getting on it, because it's like, what can't she do? So hope you're enjoying that.
So CaliKim29 on Instagram, Cali Camera Guy on Instagram. Yep. Make sure you follow us on YouTube as well. Make sure you subscribe. And we look forward to seeing you next week. Hope y'all have a wonderful, wonderful week.
Well, let's, before we sign off, why don't we just kind of show this beautiful Smart Pods set again, and we'll close with that. How about that? Can you?
Sounds good.
All right. Sounds good.
That's great. We're going to be picking some tomatoes maybe for lunch. We've got some greens, some mini tomatoes, and some peppers off there on the side. I don't know if you can see those, but we love growing in containers, and I hope you all do too.
Yeah. Let's take a look at that. Beautiful. I feel like we're on that New York talk show where the people can walk by in the background and look in the set and stuff. It's kind of cool.
All right, y'all. Have a great week. We'll see you next week. Bye-bye.
Bye.